From the NBC 10 Money Watchers this Wednesday night, checking in on the Deepwater Wind. Representatives of the proposed wind farm off of Block Island telling regulators today their project will be the first offshore wind installation in the country. Here's what Money Watcher Bill Rapley found out at that hearing for you today.
They do it in Europe, where scores of offshore wind projects crank out electricity, and now the United States is jumping on board, leasing thousands of acres of ocean for wind farms. But the first one looks like it will be based in Rhode Island.
We're very confident this will be the first offshore wind farm in the country, so we are in construction now.
He told commissioners today that all state and federal permits are in place and that the blades of what will be five turbines off Block Island, each rising almost 600 feet above the ocean, have been fabricated, and a shipyard in Louisiana is building the feet for the platforms to hold the turbines. Construction unions and environmentalists are glad to see offshore wind start up, but some say the costs are more than the struggling Rhode Island economy can afford.
As to whether this was a real project that would justify the cost of the increase in utility rates. People in Rhode Island are mad about that.
Wind power is expensive now, probably three times the cost from a gas-fired plant, but supporters say in the end, the economy will benefit. But Grabowski says he is confident that construction is already underway, negotiations are underway with financial institutions, and that the financing will be lined up, and that Deepwater Wind will be the first offshore wind project in the United States when it begins generating electricity late next year. I'm Bill Rapley, NBC 10 News in Warwick.